All right. Adjusting our settings. Let's go ahead and try that one more time. All right. So this time, same as before. We don't have the scrap recovery arm this time. But we're in a decent spot. How do you get new crew members? Events will get them for you. Okay, your jump leads you to nothing but empty space. Cool. So sometimes there are particular events that will get you crew members. There also is a particular type of ship called a slaver ship that's very common, that is one of the best ones to fight to get that event. I don't really want to go to a store here. I think we just want to boot around and look for stuff. Looks like there's a good cluster of stars over here that's going to make it easy to jet around the exit, so we're not in trouble there. We should just go up. Okay, found an asteroid belt. A pirate ship is lying in wait. Immediately moves into attack. All right. So we are going to want to focus the weapon since they have missiles. I can't tell if that's an ion bomb or a regular missile. But with any luck, our lasers will get through. Nope, not quite. Apparently don't have auto fire on, good to know. Let's see if we can get one on the shields as well, since that'll mess up there. Their whole ship will go down if we get these shields. Okay. Decent offering here. We have 5 fuel and 4 missiles, plus 9 scrap. The initial scrap on these fights is pretty bad, so like, if we're just looking for some early start materials, this might not be a bad idea. The missiles, I mean, are going to trade for more scrap later, potentially. But 4 is not a nice round number. Typically, if you trade missiles, you trade in multiples of 10. Still, 5 fuel is a lot of fuel. We should take a couple of high fuel surrenders just to make sure that our ship gets through areas. Alright. And this early, I mean, the scrap is like 14 to 17. So, we're not costing ourselves a lot. Okay. Someone is under attack by space pirates. You power up your weapons and engage the pirate ship. Okay, so we got shields and lasers again. It is a Mantis cruiser this time. This time, again, same weapon, a shield and a missile, so we want to target their weapons. Man, I'm building up a cough. I'm really hoping it's not something nasty. I don't know where I would be getting a cough from. Maybe I just messed up my throat somehow. Okay, once the weapons are gone, there's really nothing to focus on. We can go after shields, we can go after the pilot seat. It makes sense to hit the pilot seat and the engine in case they try to run away, but we're not in any particular danger. Unless we miss with every attack and they get their missiles back online. Alright, slightly better. Cool. Those all hit. Pirate ship breaks apart, you hasten to contact the civilian ship. They respond, "It's a good thing you came when you did, we'd be dead now otherwise. I'm a shipwright and I'd like to help you like you helped me. Captain offers to install a piece of equipment on your ship." Absolutely. Alright, so now we have a heavy ion. Okay, that requires us to upgrade our weapon system to 50. Heavy ions are very powerful. They're not fast, so we don't have to use this right away. But we are going to use it. The store's already gone. Let's run with the basic lasers for one more round. Especially well-armed pirate ship approaches you. Hand over one of your crew members and the rest of you can go free unarmed. No, you'll never surrender. Okay, cool. So, once again, heavy laser, basic laser. These are good interactions. We basically just want people to not have missiles, because if they have lasers, we tend to be able to manage them pretty easily. First laser always hits our shield, and then we disable the weapons. Easy peasy. From here, we can go after oxygen, we can go after the pilot seat. There's gonna be somebody in the pilot seat. We know that much. And they're offering me a human. That's interesting. So these guys are worth about 50 scrap. It's hard to get folks like that. On the other hand, the scrap from the ship is pretty useful as well. I think we'll take it. I don't know, it is slavers, so it's like a little bit tricky. Yeah, alright, sure, we'll take it. Yeah, I need somebody in sensors. This is a free upgrade to sensors since the setup is now manned, and that will give us information about their ship. So we can do one more run with the basic lasers. Alright, a rebel space station and a single fighter is monitoring this beacon. Federation activity. A number of civilian ships are docked, awaiting inspection by the rebels, and possible detainment if they are Federation loyalists. The rebels haven't noticed you yet. So we can fend for ourselves, attack and escape, which automatically gets us a ship. That's good scrap. Bribing the rebels to release the civilian ships costs us scrap, and I don't believe gets us like anything exceptionally amazing. We might even lose scrap permanently. There might be a result here that's actually quite good for losing scrap. Typically there is something on the high end. I have also taken that result and gotten nothing and just lost scrap. I think here we probably want to take the engagement. Enemy combat drone. Okay. Not a bad start. I'm really hoping that drone doesn't get too feisty. Having somebody on shields keeps the drone from hurting us too bad. I think shooting the drone repair is the best option, since we can see that they have a repair drone. So if we destroy the drone repair, then they can't repair their other stuff. And also, they can't shoot us with a combat drone, which is pretty important. Okay, from here on, we focus on the people who are repairing. They do have a med bay, so... yeah, as long as we're keeping the actual, like, drone repair setup broken, we should be good. I think I'm gonna focus both on drones and shields here. Just where the people are. Cool. Pretty simple one. And we get 13 scrap, 2 missiles, and a drone part. Not bad. Now if I want to, I can upgrade weapon control. That seems pretty useful at this point. I'm gonna go with it. Because with an ion cannon, we might actually be able to starve out a couple of ships, and that is worth a lot of extra scrap if we can get that going. Okay, this is the kind of ship we're looking for, actually. Rebel ship's weapon goes hot. Oh, but it does have a missile, so we gotta keep that in mind. Missiles are bad news. We don't want to deal with them. The heavy ion fires a little slower than the basic lasers, so we do want not to miss here. Oh man, that's rough. Is it gonna fire fast enough to get ahead of the shields? Nope. We can disable the shields for later. Alright, so we got one missile there. Our sensor man is gonna come and help. Pretty bad results there. And with the missile coming back online, let's focus our lasers where the enemies are. All right, they're trying to run, so our job is simple. We want to stop that. There we go. It didn't do a lot of work for us. Okay. So Gracie and Alex are going to be repairing the engines. We'll heal up Gracie, get our oxygen back, and we'll be good to go. Oh, a hotkey to retarget all your weapons at once. I actually don't think I've ever used that before. I'm not sure where it would be. Sure, let's look up FTL hotkeys, why not? There are 32 shortcuts. We can power things with particular buttons, good to know. Opening all doors is Z, close all doors is X, toggle auto fire is V. I don't see one that says all weapons, but we can at least use like the number keys. It's a good tip. Okay, 69%, we need to power our engines to jump. And yeah, we're good to go, so. With jumps, we're trying to get the most information possible. Beacon seems to serve as a meeting place for local traffic. Oh man, this would be a great place to have some scrap, but unfortunately we don't. So, yep, next location. This is why we keep some scrap in reserve. Seriously? Okay, no, and this is fine, actually. Fighting the ship will get us extra scrap, and it's better than delaying the rebels at this point. Okay, got missiles again, so we gotta go for... Okay. Target the heavy ion first. There we go. And all the lasers. And we can go back to fueling oxygen to the ship. I think we keep this same setup. Looks like when their weapons come back online, they're focusing on shooting the laser and not the engine, so that's good for us. Okay, one of their folks has died. If you want the FTL not to charge, you gotta damage the pilot or the engine. Cool. Alright, 16 scrap, 2 fuel, not too bad. It's a good startup. We have enough jumps left that we can do whatever we want here. Pirate offering a bribe? The bribe is not very good. Let's try to be a hero. They've got 2 lasers, we can do that. I think here we should be able to damage the weapon without firing the ion, so we'll do that. We'll keep the ion locked on the shields. Cool, that's enough. Lock down the oxygen. They don't have a pilot right now, so their FTL is delayed. We're not going to starve them out if they're trying to run away, though. Okay, cool. All right. Go to examine the ship you just saved. The pirate's victim jumps away quickly. That's pretty common. We have 50 now, which is enough to get new shields, but not super important here. We know that there isn't a particular store or any sort of like useful beacon, so we can just go here. Offering laborers for cheap, which, yeah, no, we're just going to attack the slaver scum. Now, again, with these ships, the best thing to do, if we can, is disable the oxygen. But since we don't have double shields yet, we can't just starve them out. I can give it a shot, though. Not great. We need to keep the laser shut down so that the line laser does not kill us. Okay, cool. Looking much better. Heavy ion needs to target shields. Looks like they're getting locked into a basic setup here where they're trying to deal with... Okay, they're offering another person, but this time around we don't need people as much. It's still not a bad idea to have a full crew complement as quickly as possible. But I really need the scrap right now, too. Tough call. I'd say here we still have a chance of rescuing someone from the wreckage. But it is a person. I think, no. Yeah, let's just go after them. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like so. Alright. Many lives were probably lost on that ship, but we got our scrap. Can go repair the medbay now. Okay, so we know there isn't a store in sight. There may actually be one here that we haven't seen yet. We won't be able to access it either way, since we'll be overtaken. So I think we just go here, but I can upgrade my shields first, which is notable. Add a power bar too, or I can upgrade my engines. I think having full shields is a pretty good idea at this point. So wait for repairs to finish. Good there. And away we go. Okay. So, we got another ship with lasers. I'm gonna send a mantis to teleport in. We have the right setup here, though. Okay, we are invulnerable to this ship. They have a basic laser and a small laser, so we can't die from them. If we go and kill this mantis... which is pretty doable. Yeah, medbay being off is fine, we're okay. Since we've already learned to upgrade our... ship setup, I think we can starve them out. I gotta turn off auto fire, we gotta manage this very carefully. There's a particular count for it. One, two, three, four, five. So yeah, it only takes five for the Angi to get there. One, two, three, four. Five. Ah, we missed it. That's okay, I can keep shooting at the shields and just use the heavy ion to pop the O2. I overdid it slightly. Ugh, alright. We gotta turn our own O2 on. So the plan here is to keep the heavy ion on the setup. And we're just gonna starve them out of oxygen. We gotta be very careful about it since there is plenty of room left to do it. Ah, we missed. Okay. Let's follow up with the two basic lasers then. Man. Not having the luck. Thank you for the host, Ilion. Hello, everybody. We're playing FTL. Currently trying to starve a ship out of oxygen. Wait, what? How did that hit the shield? Like, I popped the shield with the laser. Ah! Everything is terrible. Alright. In any case, I think we can do this. Got it. Okay. We can just keep that up. We should starve them out of oxygen without damaging their ship. Nice. Okay. So same thing as before. Getting a little red there. Missed it that time. We can follow up with two basic lasers and damage the O2 this time. Keep it locked down with the ion. I thought the shield was gonna come back. I messed up. Alright. Ah, that was close. I also don't have somebody managing shields, which is very silly. Ah. Alright. We made some errors. An extra power bar allows us to run the shields non-stop. I don't think it's super important, though. I think I'd actually rather have the engines be upgraded. We should take the exit beacon now, since there's no advantage to going here. This exit beacon will not be a usable location next round, so. Small rebel ship nearby. It seems to have been refitted for transport rather than combat. Does not seem to want to engage you. Demand the surrender of their goods. Prepare to secure their cargo by force. They are trying to escape. Okay. They have a missile, which is not great. We want to damage their engines and their pilot seat if we can. They have a combat drone. I don't love that. Oh, it's a laser drone. Okay, so we're fine. As long as we have a shield. So now everything should be focused on the engines. And the pilot seat if we can. But their weapons are up to... So we are going to get another missile. Okay, but they missed. We are good to go to the next sector. We can go rock controlled, which is going to be more missiles, or uncharted nebula, which nebulas just kind of suck. I think we'd rather go to the rock controlled area. I need a drone. Rock people have a particularly aggressive stance towards alien races trespassing in their space. They should tread carefully here. Well, we've got one drone part, but we don't have a drone control system. Okay. So with rock cruisers, it's really important to have good engines. I think we're going to go at least go for one upgrade. We'll keep running power light for the moment. Got 65% oxygen. That's enough to jump. Might be a little tricky for a longer term engagement, so we might let that charge just a little bit. Okay, let's take a look over here first. A motley collection of rock ships are stationed around this beacon. It looked to have resorted to a pirate's life. Defensive maneuvers. Okay, two lasers. So once again, that means that we can starve this ship out if we turn off our engines and just use our shields. It's also a good way to train shields, although it would be nice to train engines as well if we can. Basically, our plan is going to only involve like a certain amount of lasers, so we can just do that. And we're going to shoot for the oxygen. Let's just keep it on auto fire for the moment. Cool. Okay, I'm turning off auto fire. So with the rock, it's going to take more than 5 hits to repair the O2. 5, 6, 7, I think? 8, 9. Oh, wow. They have 2 oxygen bars, good to know. Alright, we're going to power the last laser. One, two, three, four. I guess he was already in the process of repairing it. The fact that it is a two-step oxygen system means that we might have a hard time dealing with it. Ah, we just got their shields. Okay. So we'll keep locking down the shields, but yeah, this might be a real tricky setup now. I think at this point we actually want to start targeting the, O2 system specifically with the heavy ion. We can just keep it locked out with the ion. That's the way to go. Why do nebulas suck? They turn off your sensors so you can't see what's inside other ships, and they have a high chance of like teleporter events, which don't award scrap and really don't award anything useful. We do have to hit with a heavy ion to starve them out of oxygen. Okay, same thing as before, we're going to pop the shield. Perfect. And just keep doing that. There we go. Oh, I stunned him. That's helpful. keep this system locked down indefinitely. But if we miss... Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get this one. It's a level 2 O2 system. Ha! So close, though. I think we just need to work on our technique a little bit. Okay. Power-wise, we can keep going. I think we're good on power for the most part. Like, we don't need to use these advanced engines and shields very often. We just need to use as much as we need for any particular setup. That store is useful, but again, I'm looking for a little bit more scrap in the tank before we go to something like that. So we'll see if we can find a different one later. Okay, quarantines again. We do have an extra crew member to go with this one. I want the scrap. Give it a shot. Your crew tries to keep the crowds in line, but the scene quickly turns ugly. Half-crazed with fear, the infected grab mining tools and push back at your crew, forcing them to retreat hastily. You barely get away without injury, but the same can't be said for the colony's leaders. You quickly leave. Oh, okay. So no scrap reward, but no losses. Pretty neutral, I would say. Receive a message meant to degrade you as aliens. You have expected an attack, but it seems to have come from a small civilian shuttle. Okay. Oh, there's our store. Okay, so if we jet around a little bit here, we can go to the store later. We do have a basic laser to sell. All right, rock ship. So we're back on that same plan as before. This time, hopefully, they don't have like a double functioning O2 system. They're on double lasers, so starving them out seems likely to be possible. I dealt 2 damage to their O2 system. Nope, but 1 damage actually does it, so they have a weak O2 system this time. So we're good to go. Two, three, four, 5, 6, 7, 8, and I believe it's on 9. 9, 10, takes 10 hits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I must have miscounted. That's fine. We got a little time to work with. All right, what's the actual count here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 hits exactly. Oh, it's on fire now. 2, 3, 4. It's only gonna take him 5 because both of them are working on it. I think one of our lasers collided with another laser. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 11. Fire it well. Man, I don't have the timing right. Still, they're out of oxygen. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Mm-hmm. And that's the game. Finally got a space. It's pretty hard to space with this ship, but the rewards are better by quite a bit. With the crew dead, you're able to take the fuel out of storage, and you also take all the scrap you can manage. 28 scrap. Much better. Okay, that was pretty good. We have enough now to go to the store, too. I think we're pretty careful here. Is there a particular direction we want to go as far as the store goes? Let's jet back. Number of privately owned ship construction platforms in the area. You find that one has a slot open for some immediate work. What's their speciality? They offer to upgrade your sensor's subsystem in exchange for some scrap. Alright, if we agree to this exchange, we get a sensor upgrade for... I think it's like a 25 cost sensor upgrade for a slightly better setup. Ah, man, I'm not actually sure that's a great deal, but I think we want it anyways. You let their team on board, and after a short time, they finish their work. Okay, so we don't need a person in sensors now. We can actually run to the shields, or the doors. And that'll give us blast doors, which protect against fire and also are harder for enemies to penetrate. They can't really get through our doors now, which is pretty handy. So we'll go here. A rock ship flies past your windows, and you recognize outcast decorations on the hull. These must be pirates. Okay, they've got flak cannons. With flak cannons, we don't mess around. Those things are very nasty. We want them to be gone. So we are going to focus on engines and just, like, not mess around with this. Okay, everything's on fire. That's a good start. From here, we can actually maybe focus on the O2, although I would be skeptical that that's going to do anything good. No, I think we just put everything into the basic lasers on this, especially since they're putting out fires. That means we're going to hit them. We're going to be able to focus on the actual enemies there. Rock cruisers... rock folk are very durable, so they're hard to kill with lasers. I think their ship hull will not expire before we are good to go. Yeah. Still, worthy for a bit of scrap. 21 scrap, one of each. Not bad, not bad. If you target the shields, can you knock them out permanently? Yes, until they are repaired. It's not a bad idea. It depends on what you're trying to target, though, since you can only focus on so many systems at a time. If you're trying to do something like starve them out of oxygen, then it's better to not focus too much on the shields, because that's hull damage to their ship that you don't want to inflict if you're just trying to kill one system. So when we're trying to space, we don't focus on the shields as much, and if we're trying to focus on weapons, yeah. Likewise, there's different reasons to focus on each part of the ship. So if you focus on the pilot, their evasion drops to zero and all your hits are guaranteed to hit, which is really, really useful, but then like that gets repaired very quickly. Pilot is also a nice seat for killing crew members, because there's always a pilot. If you're focusing on the engines, that reduces their evasion, and it also keeps it so that they can't jump away if they're the ship that's likely to rabbit. It reduces the chance that they can actually do something like that. With the oxygen system, it's specifically for spacing them, or like basically just running them out of oxygen. With the shields, it's to make it easier to hit with all of your weapons, particularly your lasers. And with the weapons, it's so that you don't get hit, which is usually the most important thing, but it really depends on what your ship's loadout is. Boarding ships are great. If you can actually get them, like, running, they will have more scrap than anybody else at the end of the game. I like playing some of the more finesse ships and trying to do spacing, since it's harder to do, and if you actually get the benefits of it without boarding, you can get, like, really, really well-kitted ships that are very, very offensive. Boarding ships are a little risky, because if you do something wrong, then you lose a crew member, everything's bad. I should have charged my oxygen while I was explaining all that, but I didn't do that, so. Okay, so now that I have level 2 sensors, I can actually see the enemy weapons charge if I go like this. I believe I'll get to see... Yeah, so I'll be able to see exactly when ships are going to fire weapons. That's not super useful, though. Most of the time you can kind of just sort of eyeball it. Whereas having the extra, like, blast doors from a manned subsystem here is really useful. So Yeah, we're good. We'll put somebody in sensors eventually, but for the moment, blast doors are more important, especially since the Red Tail's pilot location is a little bit isolated. So if somebody teleports in here and goes after the pilot, everybody else is way too far away, and the medic area is not great. But with somebody at the blast doors, we can just space this area. People who come in to get the pilot are not going to be in great shape, and they might go for the blast doors instead. It's just a better setup. Okay. Anyways, we are close to the store. I have 70 scrap available plus something to sell. And I should be able to actually do two more jumps before I hit the store. So we're going to go here, then hit the store. Settlement, still loyal to the Federation, hails your ship. They have prepared a weapon to aid your escape from the rebels. And we got a second ion weapon, which means we are looking like we are going to be in good shape. Yeah. Okay, so we might not buy anything at the store beyond, like, selling our basic lasers for scrap. Charge ion system means that we are going to be able to fire a lot of ion weapons at the same time. Also, we can fire them before the basic lasers fire up, which is, oh yeah, that's super. Okay. No, we can't hit that store at the same time. This distress beacon is connected to the store, though. And we will get away with going to both. Cool. Two ion weapons means that we're very likely to be able to space a number of different options. Oh, man. You find a number of ships fleeing from a small space station. You hail them asking what's wrong. Help, we're being overrun by some sort of giant alien spiders. I hate this encounter so much. Much like Virulent Strain, it has a pretty good chance of losing crew members. I can't remember what the reward is for winning crew members. I actually kind of want to look that up. Giant alien spiders FTL. What are your chances? I think you can get something cool out of it. Yeah, if you've got a clone bay, you're fine. If you have good drones, you're fine. If you have the bio beam, you're fine. The reward is a high amount of resources. Like a really high amount of resources, which we do need. And we can potentially spare a crew member here. Alright. Your crew slowly creeps up on a cluster of the creatures from behind without warning. The giant arachnids turn and charge. However, your team stays in control, and before long you've beaten them back. Contact the station owners. They are thrilled with your success and offer you a reward. 5 fuel, 14 scrap, and a drone. Okay. So, that was actually not a high amount of scrap, but that's okay. To the store! What you got, buddies? The Rock tolerate few aliens in their space, but even they seem to respect the wisdom of the Zoltan. A few of them have established a trading post in the husk of an abandoned capital ship. Okay, what have we got? Battery charger, reconstructive teleport. Oh, that's interesting. Automated reloader is really good for our ship in particular. Mind control is pretty good, since we can actually, like, mess with our opponent's stuff. Drone control is pretty good, since it's drone control. And hacking allows us to damage subsystems and space enemies pretty easily. Okay, so first things first, we'll sell two of our basic lasers. That gives us 114 scrap. I want this automated reloader. Of this I am certain. With our ship, that just seems like a great idea. That gives us enough to potentially get mind control or drone control. Now, I'm not planning on being a boarding ship, so mind control is a good alternative to that, where we can actually, like, get some good stuff going. We can keep a basic laser and still buy mind control. I think I'm into that. It's a fancy ship weapon, and it gives us quite a bit of extra gas without taking up too many ship slots. We'll still want drone control eventually, but that's more of a late game thing. Alright. Yeah, that wasn't a lot of scrap, unfortunately. Oh, shoot, I didn't realize how far away from the exit we were. Well, this is bad. We're just gonna have to go around the back and upgrade our engines as we go. Okay, here we go. Oh man, no, we don't want to be banged up. As soon as you arrive, you hear the telltale sounds of a teleporter and shouts reverberating through the ship. Prepare to burn fleshy meat sack aliens. Okay, so Since we are on an area with no enemies, we don't need shields. We just need our engines up. We are going to want our heals up, and we don't need weapons up, but that's fine. Okay, they teleported over here, so mind control deals with one of them. I guess he decided to go mana station? I don't even know where he's going. Just gonna sit in our O2 chamber until he's ready. Okay. Hey, come here. Come here! Goodness gracious. Alright. We need somebody to fight him. There we go. Oh, actually. Hang on a sec. It's time to go. Before our ship catches on fire. Oof. The burnt-out hull of a rock mine layer drifts by. Behind the wreck drifts a live mine, an automated drone that drills into ship's holds before exploding. It locks onto your ship's signature and heads your way. Attempt evasive maneuvers. The ship's turning circle proves too wide. The mine bites down onto the hull. You can hear it now chewing through the armor. Send someone out there to defuse it. Your crew member dons a spacesuit and exits the airlock. They make quick work of the basic device and return inside to relief all around. The mine makes good scrap pickings, too. Okay. Oof. Wouldn't solar flares be dangerous without shields? They're dangerous anyways. They go through shields, so. At least to my knowledge. Okay. I'm realizing I might want to put Alex in charge of shields and put Will in charge of sensors, since Will will gain experience slower than most enemies. I seem to recall that's the deal with Mantises. Let's double check. They have halved repair speed. Hutz's skills improve slightly faster. So did Gracie's and Alex's. On the other hand, I don't really want Will on repairs, and he's already got quite a bit of shield training, so I think we're fine. Okay, let's get our oxygen running again. We want to upgrade our engines here. We want our engines to be as high as possible before we get to the exit. I think we're going to make it to this one without scrapping the beacon, so this is actually a pretty good run. If this is invaded, though, we're going to be in trouble. All right. Well, we'll see how it goes. 73% oxygen, that's fine. Intercept chapter from an approaching rock ship. Weapons moving to engage, arm the tubes. There is no talking to these guys. Okay. Well, first things first, let's mind control the pilot. I think we can kill them pretty easily here. This is going to be kind of a rough shot, though. Okay, they do have a med bay. That's going to cause problems for us. Okay, cool. We shut down the engine. It turns out they have two shields. That's not great. I could turn off my charge ion to help deal with that. Let's do that. No, we still got hit. Okay. Bummer. Repair our O2, please. I didn't realize that thing fired twice. Okay, one rock killed the other, which is great news. Oh no, never mind. They're actually both fighting. We'll just keep their oxygen locked down while we get them into fights. But I see we also need to have the basic laser shooting at their goodies. Okay. Yeah, I need to keep them off of the bombs. That's not going to be good news. Okay, cool. This is looking a little bit more reasonable. Ooh. They're gonna keep holding on the med bay. So as long as we target the med bay, we should be good. And we can keep them fighting in there as well. I think we have a good chance of spacing them. Well, not spacing them, but killing the crew. 41 to 29. That guy's at 9 health now. Got him. No more life signs, strip it of useful materials, and I get 30 scrap. Not bad. Okay. So, O2's gassed. Make sure that everybody's good on health. Looks like Hutz needs to heal. Gotta have somebody on door control. The next jump is gonna be a big one. Power the engines. Get the pilot back in space. And we'll be good to go. Check our jump. Oh no, that's the worst. Okay. Well, I think here we're gonna invest in a power bar to make sure that we have the best possible defenses. We're probably not gonna be using our weapons very much. I believe what we're gonna be doing here is just manning shields and engines, jumping. Yeah, this would have been a very good run if we had hit this, and it hadn't been invaded, but now we have cruisers firing at us from a distance. What do their weapons look like? That might be doable. Let's see if we can mess with that. I'm not sure how we're gonna mess with that, actually. I have only one power to spare? Doesn't make sense. There we go. Yeah, if we double charge our charge ion and fire it at the weapon system, that'll give us what we want. Oh no, they have two shields. Okay. Well. So the ABS is, or the ASB is going to hit us. I think we don't quite have enough to avoid that. Oh! Oh boy. Alright. Well, I can't send Alex to repair. I think we just gotta, yep. Just gotta roll with it. Here we go. Okay, exit beacon. Rebels got here first. You must survive long enough to be able to jump to the next sector. Same thing as before, target the weapons. Alex is gonna have to go to the healing station. I'm literally gonna back and forth between like healing and engines here. Our situation is not good. Didn't get through. Don't care about the O2 being low as long as we are good. We don't have a lot of O2 though. The ASB will hit us once before we jump. Pretty bad spot for it to hit us, actually. They got our shields, that's really bad. Our weapons guy can help too. And you need to heal. Oh my gosh. Mana or oxygen. And jump! Abandoned sector. It's hard to space in the abandoned sector because there's gonna be... We don't really see a lot of this. It's a pretty rare sector. Let's give it a shot. Alright, the sector has been largely abandoned since a series of battles decimated the local population. An unusual alien race is reportedly scavenging the area. You'd best be on guard. So this is a DLC area. It's kind of hard to find. Okay, let's get everybody healing. Cool. Spacing, just like no oxygen dies of lack of oxygen. Being exposed to empty space. Okay. Time for Alex to go heal this. Yeah, so made a pathing error there, got punished for it pretty bad. We gotta make some repairs to our ship, which means we gotta find a store. even if we don't find a lot of scrap for the store. Gracie and Alex can help with repairing the shields. Oxygen is looking good. And Gracie and Alex need to heal. Now, if we press backspace, we can save the stations, and then regardless of where people are, we just press enter, and they pop right back to them, so. Oh, there's a store. Okay, so we can hit a distress beacon first. That'll get us enough scrap to repair. You find the source of a distress call, a small research station. It appears a small laboratory fire got out of control and is threatening to destroy the station. Their fire suppression system is not responding. Send your crew in a shuttle. No. Dock and try to rescue the survivors. That risks hull damage, but we're looking to get some scrap anyways for the ship, so should be fine. You pull up alongside the station and cut through their hull. You're able to rescue a few survivors, but many more are lost. One of the survivors offers to join your crew, and you offload the rest on a nearby station. Jones is an engine expert, which is actually great, because I think Gracie hasn't even mastered engines yet. So if we put Jones in on the engines, and put Gracie on the sensors, then we have a master engines person, or an expert engines person, and we get one additional power to the engines, because Zoltan add a power to any area that they're in. So now we have a full complement of crew. We have 25 scrap, which is still not quite enough to repair at the store, not unless we sell something, which I'm not going to do. I think we'll just jump again. Do I want to go here? The rebels aren't going to catch up that quickly, and we do have to hit this store eventually. Once I'm there, I'll be able to bounce around the exit pretty easily. Okay. So yeah, we can go here. One unionable shield bubble. That's good to know. Upon arrival, you are immediately surrounded by chaos. The planet's anti-ship battery is firing on a number of Lanius ships. One of the combat ships mistakenly believes your ship has arrived to assist the planetary defense's combat positions. Okay. We have an allied ASB, and all they have is a flak cannon? Oh, this is an interesting one. Okay. Well, they have a laser. We need our shields up. I don't have to use oxygen here. I want my basic laser, though, because we have two enemies that are going to be... Oh, wait. I just undid my mind control. Well, that's rude. All right. That was a weird hack. Okay, two charge. I think I'm gonna wait for three since the flak cannon's not charged yet. Yeah. Man, nothing. Okay. The flak cannon's gonna suck. Got some decent upgrades out of it. They did damage our mind control, which is actually useful to us right now. Now, Lanius can survive without oxygen, so we're not in any shape to deal with them right now. I should be shooting at their weapons, actually. Oh, man, those flak cannons are tough. Okay. I think it's time to put a little bit more power into the ion, because we need it to damage the shields. O2's getting a little low. Oh, I meant to shoot the weapons, damn it. Okay, well, the ASB did the job. The ship breaks apart. You decide to salvage it when the opportunity arises. You finish off your assailant with the help of the anti-ship battery, but the fight rages on in the distance. You'd best leave before you get dragged into it again. Okay, cool. So everybody's good. We need to do some repairs, but we have enough scrap to fuel the ship. Our main risk here is if we get into a bad fight on the way to the store, we could lose the ship. Which we'd really like not to happen. Did anyone get hit by the scrap? Huts did. So we'll turn off that. Yeah. Okay. I need some power bars here. It's okay, we're working on it. Small rebel ship is docked at the station. You try to lay low, but it spots you, power up the weapons. Okay, this isn't bad. Oh, that... So they have a defense drone and an anti-combat drone, so... We're careful about what we're charging. We might be able to get through. I don't need two shields here, I've only got one laser. Okay, we got a breach. That's not too big a deal, but we do have to deal with it. Alright, that did the trick. I think we just keep everything fired on the weapons. Unless we expect to be able to shoot down the O2 as well. I might be able to do that. I gotta get my oxygen back on. We're shutting down their weapons enough that we might be able to shut down their oxygen as well. As long as we can keep the one gun turning off. Doesn't look like the defense drones are shooting down our projectiles very much. Alright. They're certainly not making it easy for us. Nice, I killed that guy. I've not hit their O2 system once, though. Oh, okay. Well, that's not good. But there's no pilot, so if we can break the O2 system for good... Might be able to get away with some shenanigans. Gotta redirect everything to the O2 for the moment. Okay, we're good. Crap. Alright, everything on the pilot. That's busted. If I surrender, accept their surrender now, I won't take hull damage from that missile. Which I did not stop. But I don't think I care that much. Oh, Oh, and we did actually stop it. We had a ion in the air. Okay, cool. Well, that was not extremely effective, but it was somewhat effective. I have no idea why I have a mantis over here. But I do have enough scrap to repair the ship. Let's go do that now. A large transport ship undergoing maintenance hails you. Greetings, friend. We're getting out of the sector as soon as that coolant shaft is fixed, and I suggest you do the same. I half expect those damn metal freaks to come and try and melt down our ship at any moment. We're trying to offload our some inventory. Interested in buying something? Well, you got some decent stuff here, but yeah, fix all. Maybe buy some fuel if we need it. I think we're good. Whew. Did we get less scrap? That's funny. I should have just accepted the surrender. I'm struggling for power right now because the mind control made it like a little bit too tricky. So we should spend on a power bar on our next jump. Heal the mantis? Oh yeah, Will's a little bit healed. Damaged, isn't he? Image of some weak and hungry humans comes onto your screen. Those metal bastards think they can just absorb half our engines and leave us here to die. I hope you understand the need to take your ship by force. This is why we have people on the doors. Let's see if we can do the long walk around. Okay. I'll walk every- oh! Come on! Oh boy! Can't even see Will's health here. Oh! Okay, woof. Man, micromanagement on ship fights is so frustrating sometimes. Okay, everybody into the heal bay, and you need to go to the next area. Okay, cool. We spaced them all without dying. Everybody back to your posts, except for you, Gracie. Okay, oof. Yeah, no, those fights are the worst. They at least train all your people in fighting, but, like, they're super not worth it as events. They're one of the worst events to get. Just because there's no possibility to gain anything, and every possibility to lose something important. You arrive to see a well-armed Lanius craft preparing to salvage a badly damaged rebel patrol ship. Noticing your arrival, the Lanius greedily moves in to intercept its second target of the day. Man, look at this ship! So, like, honestly, I think abandoned sectors suck. Every time I've been here, I've just, like, you know, unspaceable enemies with tons of missile weapons, low scrap value. I'm not getting a lot of, like, cool benefits out of this stuff. There's two missiles and an ion, so we don't need a shield, which is poor comfort, but hey, there it is. Okay, our medbay now doesn't heal anymore. Good to know. Just gonna have to weather the missiles. Okay. Our sensors are down. Got that damage, though. If we can keep that up, we should be good. Crap. Oh god. Okay, everybody's good. We got oxygen back. I can't use the healing options, so that's something. But hey, as long as we got people on the guns. Great, so you get the sensors back up. There's no shields. Nice, we got a fire. Oh, that's not gonna last very long though, because Lanius, you know. Very good. People fighting means no repairs happening. The fires are dealing some amount of damage, which is good. We're gonna focus on the pilot. Nope, oh, he's in the main room though. I think if we shoot that, we'll be good. Got him. There are no more life signs remaining on the ship. You strip it of useful materials. 32 scrap. Woof! Alright, I messed up on the O2 there. But we got out of that alive. And we got out of that with all of our scrap. Okay. Woof. Close one. Let's check our jumps. We got no stores. I'm gonna invest in two power bars here. That just allows me to manage my power a lot better here. We have so many ship stuff to manage. We can't have a disaster every time we're like trying to do something unique. Your scans have picked up a Lanius vessel in this system. It appears to be navigating a rich debris field, harvesting the materials. You can attempt to harvest some for yourself, attack the vessel, or ignore the vessel. I've never gotten this one before. Attempting to harvest some for yourself seems neat. If I attack the vessel, then I'll probably get all of the scrap, right? Let's go for the aggro option. You go on the offensive and power up your weapons. With any luck, you'll soon have the mineral field all to yourself. Okay, they've got a flat cannon and a laser. That's not too big a deal. It would be good to have two shields on this one. How's our oxygen? 100%? We can work with that. Just gonna charge up our ions. And fire before the flat cannon goes off. Perfect. Alright, and now I can just keep hammering the shields and the weapons. And without weapons shooting at us, we could do our mind control as much as we like. Ooh, got a fire in there. That's good crew damage. Okay, one of them's dead in the fire. The fire should... Well, it won't spread because there's no oxygen on the ship. We're almost there. We just have to hit this guy or this gal one more time. Sophia. Bye, Sophia. There are no more lifestines remaining on the ship. You strip it of useful materials. Oh, it looks like you interrupted the Lanius before they had a chance to scavenge much from the debris. And you make up with a very good haul. 37 scrap on top of 37 scrap means we have just a big old pile of scrap. Oh, I didn't realize this one didn't connect up. So we are gonna double up on our jumps, which is a little sad. That's okay. A ship with conspicuous pirate markings is orbiting a nearby moon, broadcasting a simple message claiming to have equipment available for sale. This guy, like, he sells random weapons, but honestly it's way better to attack him and get the scrap, unless you have a particular need for a weapon. Oh, he's got a cloaking device. Bleh. I don't like that. Huh, they have a Lanius pilot. Let's get their pilot, since that means the other guy has to fight him in zero oxygen. I do need better engines, because we are getting shot up by missiles quite a bit here. Oh wow, that mind-controlled crew member is dead already. Lanius are insane. That's part of the reason why we went here, is because there was a chance we could pick one up. Okay, I think we're gonna go for everything at the weapons. Oof! Kind of a close one. Let's get our sensors back up. Nice, we burned out the weapon system. They have a clone bay, so we're probably not going to be able to space them. Oh, actually, maybe we can. Considering the way their current setup looks. I think we're gonna get him. Do have to get my own oxygen going. Alright, that's one crew member dead. We did hit their clone bay with an ion, so we got that going for us. Clone bay is locked out with Ion. They have no crew members left. Alright, there are no more life signs remaining on the ship. Got through a clone bay, that's excellent. Alright, we're in great shape here. If we get a store, that's a huge advantage for us. With 112, I can afford to upgrade my engines at least once. Let's do that before we go further. Do we want a power bar as well? I think we can afford to stockpile a little bit. Receive a transmission. Sorry, sir, this is nothing personal, but we're under orders. The rebel ship's weapons go hot. What do they got? They got lasers. We are pretty good against lasers. We should be fine. This is going to be a focus on their O2 system. Maybe not. Our shields aren't that great. Okay, we can probably focus on their O2 system. Oh wow, their mid bay is very good. Eek! I messed up with a basic laser, so I am gonna get shot again. That did the trick, though. Hey, we killed one of their people. Not bad. With mind control shutting down that stuff, and we're doing. us doing enough damage to their weapons. I think we can space them. It's gonna be close. You're considerably more well-armed than we thought. That's a decent offer. But if they don't try to run away, we can get everything. Let's mind control the O2, guys, so that there's nobody fixing the O2. Good job. Alright, and that's it. They are not gonna have oxygen. We gotta turn ours back on too. There are no more useful life signs remaining on the ship. You strip it of useful materials. That is 100 scrapos. With 100 scrap, I can upgrade my shields to the next level. It's a pretty worthy endeavor, although it'll leave me power hungry for a while. I think that's fairly good this early. Let's give it a go. Since we don't know there's no store for a while. There appears to be some sort of research station near a pulsar, though it's hard to tell since a portion of it has been melted. The Lania ship that has been working at it moves to intercept you, totally oblivious to the threat of EM pulses. Okay, so EM pulses damage random systems. Their systems are a big laser and a missile. Oh, and a little laser and a hacking drone? Okay, I don't like this. Okay, but they're on our sensors, so that's not the end of the world. That's very bad. While we have zero evasion, we should devote all of our power to our shields. Cool. And now we just try to shut their weapons down forevermore. Same as we usually do with the Lania ship. Gotta get our oxygen running as well. What's not running right now? Our mind control's working, so that's good. Got good information about what's going on in their ship. Lit a fire. You receive a one-word message from the enemy ship, surrender. You assume they are asking to surrender rather than demanding your surrender. They will not accept surrender. Not with 8 health left on King here. Nice. Find a drone schematic on their ship. With no crew to stop you, you can install it on your own. Okay, with the amount of damage the ion pulse has been doing to our shields, we want to try to get away without it doing that to us. Okay, this time it's on our weapons. That's not great. It keeps triggering before we can actually do anything. If we go to the exit now, we get away without having to deal with anything. If I don't go to the exit now, I'll be able to manage 2 more scrap runs before I go to the exit. I think that's probably the better bet. Though it means that I'll have to invest pretty deep in my engines. You pass a civilian ship that warns of the nearby Lanius. One of them attacked a civilian transport and started to melt their fracking hull, but then the weirdest thing happened. Another metal ship actually fired on its companion until it backed off. Apparently there are disagreements among the Lanius about what should be salvaged. Now, but that didn't get me anything useful. We needed scrap to upgrade our engines one more time before we left, but okay, Alanius Merchants appears to have significantly improved translators. You clearly understand their message. Metal content more than sufficient. Does your ship care to exchange resources for excess metal? All right, so we have two options here. We can agree to the exchange, which is 20 supplies. That won't help me with my engines, but it's definitely not a bad trade. If I decline but ask about their translation device, I believe I can purchase it? And I think that gets me a Lanius crew member. I'm not sure if I have use for a crew member right now. I think I'm just going to agree to the exchange. After the exchange is complete, they leave without a reward. Oh, there's a store over here. It's not connected to the exit, though, so we gotta go. Can I upgrade my engines? 60? No, not gonna happen. So it's time to jump. Found the exit beacon, but the rebels got here first. Survive. Yay, drone! Yeah, the combat drone's gonna be really good. Okay, so... keep our shields running for sure. Shoot up their weapons if we can. They have a teleporter. I should have kept that in mind. It's fine, though. We don't need oxygen right now. We're good there. Get a second person in the pilot's... yeah. Station? Cool. I could space him. I don't think that's super useful. Let's just get a second person on Debbie here. Charge Ion might be able to shut down the missiles, but I honestly don't care about the missiles. We have good enough shields to be okay. Wow! Debbie here is a capable fighter. Let's get Gracie out of here. No luck. Oh my god, if that had hit my medbay. Alright, our engines are still at 5. And we can get out of here before the ASB fires. To the rebel-controlled section. Once the Federation forces were scattered, the rebels came down hard on the locals here. Between the tax collectors and military bases, the rebel presence in this sector is high. Somebody's in our O2 system. Can you repair my ship for a moment? I need a little help here. Oh, wow, I'm not going in there. You just fix that yourself, Ohm. Good job, friend. Alright, Alex can handle the rest. Thanks, Ohm. Whew. Alright, ship's looking pretty good. We got a bit too much damage, I would say, for the start of an area. But we're making good bank. We're using our ion weapons well. We could use a little bit more weaponry on the ship. We have a fourth weapon slot. I'd like to make use of it. Gotta add a little more power to the ship as well. A battery would be good. I think we're gonna be stockpiling for a bit. There's a nebula here. You arrive to find yourself extremely close to a star. Oh man, hostiles on a... it's fine, I guess. Mantis friends, I need you here. You can run. Oh, they slipped through the door somehow. Interesting. Let's close up those doors. Cool. Right, time to go. A rebel automated ship. Does not engage and seems to be patrolling around a long-range sensor station. Attack the ship to get to the sensor station? Absolutely. I got a laser. So mind control is going to be useless here. Want everybody back at their stations. That laser is not very good, so with 3 shields we might actually be able to just sort of deal But I am going to need some form of damage to the ship. Let's just fire a ion at that. This would be good engine training if we needed it. We don't, but notable nonetheless. Okay, since everybody's good, we can get some people healed. And we can get our O2 running as well. Looking solid. It's gonna take a little while to kill this ship because we only have the one basic laser. It's actually fairly hard to destroy hull. If I shoot the pilot, I'll be able to hit every shot, which should help with the missing with the laser. Hey, a fire! Not bad. That might actually deal enough damage to the weapons for us not to have to worry about them for a while. Okay. Apparently I turned off my oxygen. I don't remember doing that, but okay. After all the hard work we put in to get everybody back to full health. Alright, back to your stations, friends. Good job. Oh yeah, I thought we had somebody manning the door, but I guess they were just in the boarding room and in combat, which is not the same as manning it. Okay. There's a store. If we access it, it might be better to try to go around. So with full information, we know that there's two stores that we want to hit. We also know that we can pretty easily hit these two ships to get scrap. If I go to this store, I'm going to be forced to swing through an ion storm, which is not that hard to deal with. As long as we're not near an asteroid field or a... Oh, this is also just an ion storm. Ion storms are fine. Let's go here first. Another AI, okay. Huh. This one's not gonna be too hard. Same thing as before, we're gonna target the shields. Oh. Excuse me, give that back. Mort is mine, thanks. Okay. Man, not having good luck here. Bug off. Oh, I didn't need to shoot that laser. We're trying to wait for the shields to open up before we do that. Finally. No. Whoa, wait, he broke through my shields? Well, that sucks. We're gonna need two people on the oxygen. Maybe three. Be a really good idea to lock down the mind control, too. Since we are, yeah, we have people who need to be repairing. Okay, heal him up. Wow, both guns coming up. That's not great. Come on. Stop that. The good news is the lasers are not opening us up too much to a lot of other problems. Bad news is they are actually like doing a very good job of repairing. Or maybe it's just the ion damage we're dealing. In any case, everybody can return to their stations. Cut that out. Might be time to start damaging the shields. Keep the heavy ion focused on the shields. I should be able to keep them locked down. Stop it. How are people doing on training? I've got a master pilot. We've almost mastered shields. Ooh. Repair burst. Alright, that'll be handy for a little bit. We'll probably end up selling it, but it's definitely not a bad weapon. Basically, you spend a missile to target any area, and it should repair that section. Which is super cool. Alright, go into the next area. Another AI. I guess we're in a rebel-controlled sector, and that's why we're getting this so often. Well, this ship sucks, but also, like... I need to get the pilot area specifically. This is gonna be pretty awful. The good news is we have enough guns to get through it. Come on! That's better. No, we can't do any more cloaking! Oh my gosh, he has too many different defensive mechanisms. We might actually have a really hard time dealing with this. It's gonna be really hard to get rid of this. Jump is imminent. Yeah, we got no choices. We're just missing every shot. All right, fleet pursuit doubled for one jump. Well, am I going to that store? Stop here, I can sell my repair bomb, maybe get drone control. We'll have to go to an ion field next, but I don't think the rebels can hit that. It's gonna be close. I guess we just gotta try for it. Discover a resupply station used by rebels and civilians alike. You transmit your fake ship identification, and for once they don't seem to recognize your ship. Try to assume the air of a local as you prepare to dock. Ooh. Ooh. Well, chain ions are disgusting. As is the backup battery. Let's sell a repair burst. Are we going to keep our clone bay? I'm really excited by this chain ion. Once I buy this, I'm totally dedicated to spacing enemies. I think I can live with that. Let's get the backup battery. The combat drone's really useful. But we might want to sell it to repair our ship here, since we don't have drone control yet, and we're probably not going to get it. Considering our current ion setup, I think we're going to be pretty focused on... No, we're going to need the combat drone later for the final fight, because I can't just not deal damage in the final fight. Okay, we can make it to the Pulsar. No problem. A rebel captain appears on the screen. I thought we had been doomed to backwater assignments. This is my chance to get back in the commander's good graces. Charge the weapons! Okay. You got a hacking system? That's rough. How do we want to do this? I don't have enough power yet to charge the chain ion. Oh god. Boarding drones, huh? Boarding drones are the worst. Uh-huh. Well, we can fight it off, but they're gonna launch another one eventually. The central thing I need to do here is... Okay, we turned off their weapons, that's good. Try to get their shields down a little bit. The ions disabled my shields. This sucks. Our shields are down, our engines are low. We gotta wait for a while to get our guns back online. Meanwhile, there's a giant hole in my ship. I hate this fight. We could exit it. I'm taking a lot of damage here. That's gonna take me a while to find something useful out of it. Yeah, screw this. Let's go here. Okay. Quit it. Looks like the boarding drone broke down, which is good news. Oh no! I wasn't paying attention to Alex. I was too focused on all the other things we had to do. Alright, our doorman is broken. And we have a fire somewhere on the ship that I can't see. We're just gonna open up all the doors. Okay. Man, those Pegasus missiles are a pretty serious business. Okay, put the missiles down, we can focus on the rest. Missiles back up, we have to focus on those. Their pilot is back up, we gotta break that. Okay, that's gone. Now there's no charge in the FTL. That did it. Ugh. All right, well that was a frustrating fight. I'm not going to that store. I don't have the scrap to do anything with that. Just gonna hit another nebula. A heavily damaged Federation ship is hiding in the nebula at this beacon. Before we have time to make contact with them, they fade into the nebula. Attempt to follow and help them. While searching fruitlessly through the nebula, you stumble upon a rebel ship. Okay, cool. No sensors, so no mind control here. Might as well just put somebody on fixing that hole. Get our shields back up to speed. And then we can focus on their weapon systems. Hey, how's it going, Thindelgard? Not too much is up at the moment. We are trying to get this ship to get to its final bit of value. Nice. Okay. If we get a little bit of damage on the shields and a little bit of damage on the ions, we should be okay. That is a lot of lasers. Still missing a lot. I wonder if I shouldn't put a little damage on the pilot seat. Lock out the pilot seat for any amount of time. And that's the evasion gone. You're not gonna suffer the same fate as Alex, friend. Let's get some oxygen running. Okay. Pellet seed is shut off. Guns are looking pretty good. Gotta get the battery running again to get the shield going. Okay. And now we're good to go wherever. It doesn't look like I can shut down the oxygen here. We might want to try it. Okay, never mind. Everyone after the pilot seat. I messed that up. I might take that surrender. It's a good amount of fuel, and I don't know if I can actually kill them before they get the FTL running. Let's just take it. Alright, get some money on the sensors. From here, I can go to the next nebula or go to this ship. I think we're a little tired of nebulas at the moment, so it might not be a bad idea to go to the ship. What options do we have for power right now? I need to invest in piloting at some point. But I'm also hurting pretty badly for power bars. Let's buy one. Rebel scout on the attack approach to a small refueling outpost. The weapons are charged, but they're not firing yet. Intervene to defend the outpost. Okay, what do they got? Flat cannon, lasers. These fights are getting pretty hard. But this time I can see them, so that's a help. With the flat cannon and the double lasers, we want to focus as much as we can on their weapon systems at first. I don't have anybody on the doors to hold them in. Okay. There goes the flat cannon. Get our engines up to code. Not bad. Got some damage on them. I think I can take the Mantis up here to finish off this guy. Okay, cool. Oh boy. Damage-wise, we're doing fine. We're still just using a single basic laser to do all of our, like, damage to the ship. So that's kind of awkward. How's their O2 system? It's bad. I'm not even sure how I got a... Oh no, their teleport's on cooldown because their ship sucks, not for any other reason. Nice! We got a boarding party. That actually should work out well for us, because they don't have healers. Hmm. Now they have a lot less people just running the ship. Might even be able to just... Oh, that's beautiful. That's exactly what I needed. Get our engines back up to par. Yeah, flat cannon didn't do anything. Oh, but the laser follow-up did. We lost our basic laser. I can get this last shield bar. Not quite. Got it. There it is. The outpost hails you. The pompous bastards expected free service just because they defeated the Federation. Take this for the help. All right. 99. So, upgrading the backup battery would help me with my power concerns. I cannot hit this area, so it's best to go here first. Oh, Will's wounded. I should have done something there. Alright, we've been boarded, and we can't see who, but there they are. Need all hands on deck. We should power oxygen and med bay just to make sure that we get everything. Okay, I think we're good. As long as one of our Zoltan doesn't die. Yeah, let's get Mord out of here. Mantis is a little wounded too. I think we're okay. Yeah, might as well go 2-on-3 for a little bit. Perfect. Okay, everybody's good. Yeah, it sucks that we're down one crew member, but... Gracie back to the sensor room. Hutt's back to the pilot bay. And then we can just press enter and send everybody else back where they belong. No scrap for that. I got some pretty competent fighters on our crew now. We need to get a piloting upgrade. Might want to go for two. But I can probably wait on that. Let's buy backup battery and a power bar, and then go into the Ion Storm. Jump into a sector of the Nebula beset by a... Oh, automated Rebel Scout. Okay, we can do that. Yeah, this Rebel Scout sucks. Cool. Doesn't have mind control, so we can turn off the med bay. Power all the weapons. And power our shields with a battery. And we're good to go. Shouldn't be too hard to kill. That's the thing about ion storms, is that they target... Let's focus on the pilot, since we have enough to withstand the rest. Good stuff. Oh, but they have a missile up now. I don't like that. No. Fine, we'll focus on your weapons instead. We're wasting a couple of basic laser shots, but by and large everything's shooting fine. Running out of O2? Okay. As long as we keep their guns locked down, they can't really do anything to us. Weapon system is pretty defunct at the moment. From here on out, we want to focus on the pilot seat and the shields. As long as we can keep both of those locked down, we're good to go. Okay, cool. Decent amount of scrap. A chain ion requires 3 power to man. It might be better than the charge ion, but we're gonna have to get an upgrade to the weapon control before we can actually go for it. So we've been waiting on that. Jump to jump. Yeah, they won't be able to get to the exit, so. Low on fuel and have a proposition. That's a pretty bad offer, but drone parts sell for a lot? I don't know, I don't really have a drone control. And fuel is golden. It's a pretty good trade, we'll give it a shot. Turn our shields on. Oxygen's good. Will needs healing again. Okay, to the exit. Sensors have picked up a refugee ship drifting through the system, no doubt one of many fleeing the rebel advance. Doesn't appear to have detected you, or else it is trying to avoid notice. Hail them. So you hail the refugee ship, a slug ship jumps into the system. It was hunting the refugee ship for sport, and now they found you instead. Okay, we can deal with that. Get the weapons guy. Oh, are they immune to mind control? Yes, they are. Okay. Good to know. Well, I have all the weapons I need. We don't need to use mind control ourselves. Our system looks like it probably isn't going to be able to deal with 3 shields very effectively. We might be able to space them. It's a chain ion, though. Let's keep focused on their shields. I don't think they're going to be able to get through to me. Not with that shot chance. Making good progress on the O2. Now the O2's on fire. That's gonna consume even more oxygen. Still on fire, good times. Two of the slugs evacuated for the med bay. That's a good sign. Now we're just all in on the O2. Oops, fired my basic laser at the wrong time. Alright. The med bay is the other thing we need to hit. Oh, whoops! I missed how much hull they had left. Whoopsie daisies. The refugee ship claims the slugs have been hounding them since they left their homeworld. As a gesture of goodwill, and seeing how effectively you dispatch the enemy ship, they offer up what supplies they can spare. Alright. We can finally get that upgrade. Let's put the chain ion in place of the heavy ion. It's going to require a little more power to run. We can do that pretty easy. I might want to upgrade my oxygen at this point, since I'm doing a lot of, like, running without oxygen. It's cheaper than upgrading a power bar to some extent. It allows us to quickly fill up on oxygen while turning our oxygen on and off. Alright, next sector. Abandoned sector or Uncharted Nebula? We had decent results from the last abandoned sector that we hit, and I am not a fan of nebulas, so yeah, let's go.